Alright, so we're going to be doing an Airhead annual on this E3 R100. This is a customized bike. So we're going to take you step by step what we do for the annual. Alright, let's start with the oil. Drain plug. This uses an 8mm Allen bit socket. So we're just going to undo that. I'm going to start off with a clean oil pan to see if anything comes out. Also make sure you remove your old crush gasket. Alright, so this bike obviously has a few needed repairs that we'll write down and let the customer know about. Alright, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to start draining the gearbox. The drain is right up here. If you can cover this up, it'd be better to do that. We're just going to be cleaning this piece of the exhaust with spray clean. Need a 5mm Allen bit socket for here and a 17mm 6-point socket for these lines. When we take these lines off, we're going to be replacing the crush gaskets when we install them. First, we'll start with the lines. Just to make it easier to get the thermostat out so we could access the oil filter. If this wasn't here for some reason, you don't have to remove the lines. Millimeter Allen bit. This one doesn't seem to want to go in too well. Let me get a hammer. so we don't round off the head. There's a third bolt back here. This one. That one we're going to use a different tool for, only because the exhaust is keeping us from going straight onto it, as you can see. Alright, so we're going to use two different tools. We're going to use a regular Allen key to break it free, and then we're going to use a ball end Allen key. You can see the difference. Okay, this one, it allows you to remove or install a bolt on an angle. Use this one to break it free. And this one will grab it, even though it's not straight on there. Alright, so when we remove this, we just want to make sure that we try not to get any oil on the rack for the customer. Okay. Let's see if I can clean this a little bit. So all the gaskets stayed on the block. We'll give this a quick clean and show you how they go back together in a few minutes. So that was one washer. Here's a second one. And again, you'll see this in a few minutes. And then the metal shim. Okay. Now you just use a pick and just try and get this moving. Gonna let that drain for a second. Okay, so the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna check the valve clearances and adjust them if necessary. So we're gonna remove the spark plug wire. Spark plug and the valve cover. To remove the valve cover, we need a 10 millimeter wrench for the bolts on the back. There's one here, and then there's another one right up in here. And then a 13 millimeter for over here. Start with these first. Usually a washer on there. So that's one side. Okay, sometimes the washer doesn't want to come out so easily, but that's okay. When we pull the cover off, the washer will drop. Just don't forget it. There will be a washer right here too. You can see this one is moving. Again, this will come out with the valve cover. Alright, so if the washer does bind you up, you just gotta make sure you get it off. If the gasket looks intact, or if it's, we're gonna reuse it, if the gasket looks like it has any kind of damage, or if it breaks off when you're pulling it off the head, you're gonna go ahead and replace it. Spark plug, and then we're going to do the same process on the other side. Okay, you can use a 13/16 spark plug socket. It'll have a little rubber piece in there so it doesn't break the ceramic on the spark plug. So it's usually a better idea not to pull these out with the motor hot. You can possibly damage the threads. And always take a look at the spark plug. On this bike here, looks like we're gonna recommend new spark plugs, and we're gonna be doing some tuning to the carburetor later. Okay, so while the other oil filter is draining, I'm gonna show you this. This is because it has the oil cooler on there. It's split in the middle to make it easy to get out. This is the side that will go in first for the rubber washer. All right, and this is the side that we just pulled out with our pick. We have new crush gaskets for the, these are the bolts for the oil cooler lines, and we have new crush gaskets for them. You need two, one on each side of the oil line. Now with our oil kit, this is still dripping out oil, but that's okay. You're going to have a new O-ring, okay, it's going to fit right in there. And then we're going to install a gasket on this flange. I like to just use a little grease just to hold it in place for when I'm putting it back up. This is purely just to hold this in place like this. So this way it doesn't shift on you. We're gonna put these in when we actually go to physically put this up, because you're gonna put the O-ring on. Well, this will be last. The metal shim will go in first. So it's gonna be set up just like this. So that's what your setup is gonna look like. All right, so now we're gonna pull out the oil filter and continue with the rest of the service. Okay, so there's your old filter. Okay, now there's something else you should look for when you have your oil filter out. All the way in the back, on this side, you're gonna see a bolt, and there's gonna be a scratch mark, like a dent, on the case and on the bolt. That's an alignment mark. You want to make sure that they're still lined up when you change your oil filter. So here you have your drive shaft, which has oil in it. Okay, it's the oil fill plug. There's a drain plug right underneath, which you'll see in a minute. And you also have your final drive, which has this vent up here, but we use this to fill the oil. Down here you're gonna have a drain plug. And over here, you have another plug, just so you can see how much oil you actually have in there. So we could take that out, and when the oil starts pouring out, then you know that you're at the right level. Okay, so let's get started. This is also gonna be a 17 millimeter, 6 point. You could use a 12 point, I prefer 6 point. This one's gonna be a 19. We'll get started with this one. Again, don't forget your crush gaskets. Alright, so we're going to take the top off now. We're just going to use a 17 millimeter wrench. So I have a crush gasket on it as well, and that should also be replaced. Okay. I'm gonna squeeze in another piece of cardboard here. I'm gonna make a big mess. This one is gonna be a 17 millimeter. Sometimes they're a little tight coming out. Gonna check these threads. Again, this one also has a crush gasket. We're gonna take that out. You never want to reuse these because they get too soft. Well, threads look pretty good on this one. Thank you. Okay, so we're gonna let these continue to drain, and we're gonna move on to checking the valve clearances on this bike. Okay, so in order to turn the motor over, we're gonna need to remove this front cover here, as well as this oil cooler. We have to disconnect the battery negative cable in order to safely remove that cover. This bike, the customer has an additional harness put on here, so we're going to remove it from the battery. If you're not familiar with positive negative, you always want to remove negative first. It's also the last one to go on. Your negative cable is easily identified because it runs from the battery post right down here to your gearbox. So this is where it's actually grounding the bike and the battery. And it's usually a 10 millimeter bolt. Might be different depending on the battery. Okay. So we're going to put this aside. Now, if this bike did not have this additional harness here, you could have disconnected it right from down here. But if you did remove it from here without disconnecting this harness, you'd still have battery power going through the bike because of this wire. All right, with that removed and out of the way, we're going to remove the oil cooler. Get this side loose, and then remove the bolt on the other side. Okay, when you remove it, just keep a rag handy for any oil that can drip out. Alright, next thing is to remove this cover. On this bike, you're going to only have the two bolts that use the 5mm Allen socket. It's a pretty long bolt, so it's can't misplace that one. Okay, we're gonna now take a 6mm Allen bolt, just like Allen socket, just like this one, but a 6mm, and we're gonna put it in here and turn the motor clockwise. to check our valve clearances. So now I'm going to take the plug out over here on the left side of the engine. All right. It's just a little rubber plug. Now, if you want to come on this side, this way you'll be able to see it a little bit better. We're going to take the 6mm Allen socket, put it in here, and just turn the motor over clockwise, like I said. And we're going to wait for it to come up and see the OT mark. All right, so now that we have it to the OT, when the pistons are on top dead center. Okay.
Okay, so we're going to do our valve check next. For more valve check videos, check out our YouTube page. All right, so now we have our mark set on OT. Okay, and the best way to find out if which side is on top dead center and which side is on valve overlap is if the push rods rotate, which these do. If they don't move at all, that side is on valve overlap, and you're going to adjust that your next go around. So this side, we have play on our rocker arms, so we're going to go ahead and adjust this side. Okay, so the valve specs, you should always double check to make sure that your bike, which ones they have. But ours for this bike is going to be 0.004" on the intake and 0.008" on the exhaust. I'm just going to fit it right here between the top of the valve and the rocker arm. Okay, I can tell already that this side is a little bit too loose. When you put it in there, it should go in freely, but you should feel a slight drag on there. In this case, we don't, so we have to adjust it. And now we're going to check the exhaust. See, now this one is in just the right spec because it moves freely, but you can feel drag on it. Okay, to adjust our clearance, you're going to adjust over here at the push rod. This particular bike uses 12mm, some of them use 11mm. Okay. With this nut loose, we can give it a little extra turns back out just so you have room. And you're gonna turn this adjuster right here. Okay, that's gonna, you can feel the rocker arm moving on the feeler gauge. That's obviously too tight. A little more. Okay, that feels pretty good. Just double check because it's moving it a little bit. It does have some drag. Okay, now when you tighten this, you're going to recheck this after you tighten it. Okay. See, we have to readjust it one more time. When you tighten this nut, it pulls this whole adjuster up, and you saw the feeler gauge shift. We're going to loosen it again. Get my hands to work. Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you may want to go just a little bit tight, so when you snug it down, you have the right amount of clearance. In which case, this time we do. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and repeat the process on the other side.
Okay, so after turning the motor over, over here at your alternator, we found the OT mark again, and then we adjusted the valves on the right side of the motor. Okay, so now the valves are all set. And while the oils, make sure you put in your plug for your timing lock. And while the oil is finishing draining, we're going to go over some small checks, because part of the annual service is we're going to grease the swing arm pivots underneath here. Some of the bikes are different. They have grease fittings on the side stand as well as on the clutch release lever. This one doesn't, but we're still going to right down here, we're going to remove this cable and put some lube on the barrel there. We're going to apply some grease in here so we see it come out between the swing arm and the frame. This bike is custom, so we don't have an air box in here to check, but these air filters look okay. We're going to see if the customer wants us to service them. And then we're also going to, using our tread depth gauge, we're going to check the depth of the tires in three different spots. Okay, and this way these tires are obviously good, but we'll let the customer know of the readings. And we're also going to use our tire pressure gauge. And we're going to check the tire pressures. Now this one needs a little bit. Okay, right there, 30 pounds. That's where it should be. 30 in the front, 32 in the rear. And the valve cap. Don't forget that. And as part of the Airhead annual, we're going to continue with our QC sheet, where we'll be checking the lights afterwards. And like I said, this bike does have some work needed to be done to it that the customer requested. So we'll check off as much as we can. We're going to check our warning lights, our drain plugs. When we install them in a few minutes, we're going to torque them down. The pinch bolts, which for the front and rear tires. Tire tread depth and pressure, and just going to give it a good safety check, make sure everything's nice and tight. Okay, so now the next step is we're going to start putting all the drain plugs and our filter back in, and then we're going to reassemble the valve covers and the front cover and reconnect the battery. Okay, so like I said, make sure the rubber part goes in first. And what I should have mentioned earlier is that when you pull the old one out, make sure that the rubber comes out with it and it's not stuck in there. But we've already verified that. Okay, so it's, being that it's split in two, it makes it very easy to get back in. And just set it back in there as far as you can. Here we have our thermostat set up. We're gonna stick the metal shim in there first. Just make sure it sits in the groove, it doesn't fall out. Alright, all this stuff is on here pretty tight, so we're gonna go ahead and just bolt it back in. So just like that, obviously these go to the front for the lines. Okay. Just
Make sure nothing shifted, nothing came down on you. Bottom one next. I like to keep some pressure on the thermostat just so that nothing moves while I'm putting it back together. So now we're going to end up putting the cover on, and that way we can mount the oil cooler and reattach the lines here. Okay, so now we have the oil cooler back on. We're just going to leave this loose until we have our lines installed. Alright, again, so your bolts with your new crush gaskets on. So you're going to put the bolt in and put the other new crush gasket on the other side. Okay, now the reason we left everything loose is just so that when you're threading this back in, nothing gets cross-threaded. cross-threading is really bad. Okay, 17 millimeter socket. You're gonna tighten these down. Want to make sure that nothing really moves, so it's in the way, not rubbing against anything. And you're gonna tighten them till you feel the crush gasket squeeze down. Right there. Okay, now before we road test this bike, we're going to make sure that we clean up all these points with some brake clean so we can check for any leaks after our test ride. Okay, so we have most of the drain plugs put in. We have the gearbox, the drive shaft, and the final drive. And we're going to put in the engine drain pan bolt, and we're going to start filling them up. I've already filled up the drive shaft. It's a little bit difficult because of where the fill hole is, so I use an old syringe. It takes a little time because it uses the gear oil, the 80W90. So, but you can find something suitable just to get it in. Okay, so now we're gonna install the engine drain bolt with the new crush gasket on there. Okay, it installs back here, so. Torque it down to 30 newton meters. My torque wrench turns. Okay. Okay, so that's all set. And again, we'll double check all these after our road test for any leaks. Okay, we're going to install the engine oil. You obviously have your max mark and your minimum. So when we check the oil level, you're going to have the dipstick sitting on top of the threads. You're not going to thread it down. You're going to leave it here. Pull out the dipstick and then check the level, and we want to be at max or close to it. Still need more for right there.
150. Do we like Mel never even got put on any of this. He was just like, do it, right?
Pretty much. I mean, 150 for paint is not bad at all.
No.
Did Russ give you a better quiz?
Oh, we didn't on the sun cost, by
the way. I tried to figure it out. I didn't actually mean for him to call. I don't really care. Well, then we can.
Which is fine. I would rather get an answer.
Well, then we can resend it if we get it figured out.
Okay, we're pretty good right there. We're almost at the max. Now, unlike the other oils on the bike, this is the one oil after we do the road test that we're going to recheck the level after we complete the road test. We're just filling up the gearbox with the gear oil. Just waiting for it to drain down the funnel. Okay, so a little hard to see, but this gearbox takes 800 cc's, and you can just barely see the fluid below the thread. Light. Okay, again, so we're using a new crush gasket, and we're just going to tighten it till we feel it squeeze down. There we go. Right there, it squeezed. Okay, these rubber caps, they just fit up in there. These are relatively new caps. So they're very easy to get out, so you can just use a screwdriver to pry them out. Sometimes if they get old, they get brittle, and you'll have to replace them because the edges will break off. We're going to be releasing this nut down here. Alright, so we're going to be using a 13mm offset box wrench and a 4mm socket Allen to release this nut down here. We're also going to be using this BMW special tool to release the top caps. We'll show you that later. Okay, so you're going to remove the nut and the washer. This is not a crush gasket. This is just a regular lock washer. It's actually a wave washer. The crush gasket is located on the inside of these forks. So you'll see that when we drain them, after we're done, if they're all empty, we're just going to reassemble them. There won't be any changing on the crush washer because it's inside the fork tube. Now we're going to repeat this process on the other side, and we'll begin draining the fork.
Okay, so we have nuts off the dampening rod. I have this a little bit loose. going to use a scissor jack, and we're going to lift it up just a little bit, just to help get the fluid out. Next, we're going to remove these caps. There we go. Starting to drizzle out a little more. Okay, that's going to take a little while. And to remove these caps right here, you need this special tool. Don't know if they still make it, but you can easily make one yourself. Or as you can see here, somebody used a punch to open it and also to close it. But this tool just fits right in there like that. And that's how you open and close it. And there's also a gasket underneath here that we're going to be changing out to. Okay, so now we're going to fill the final drive oil. This takes 350 cc's for this model. Okay, and now all we have to do is put the cap on. And remember, this is your vent for the final drive, so if for some reason this is lost or damaged, don't just put anything in there to fill up the hole. Just get a replacement from BMW, which you get straight from us online at our website. Okay, that's it for now. Okay. After it's all done draining, you're gonna reinstall your hardware. And I would recommend holding off putting the rubber cap in until after your road test to make sure you have no leaks. Next step is we're going to fill the fork with oil. Okay. When you are filling them up, you should go a little bit on the slower side to give the air a chance to escape. Just makes a mess, so you just want to pull it down. Okay. So now we got the fork oil in. We're just going to close it up, and then we're going to repeat the process on the other side.
So we have a new crush gasket in here. On some bikes you may have to remove the handlebars, but in this particular model you don't have to. Okay, so like I said, we're going to finish filling up the fork fluid on the other side. This bike has a few more repairs that the customer requested, so we're going to be stopping this video here. So that's all for today. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.